Isn't it scary that there are people who go missing every year and nobody will ever know where they went or what happened to them? Today's Mystery Monday will cover the unsolved cold case of Dail Dinwiddie. Dail Boxley Dinwiddie was a 23-year-old young woman living in Columbia, South Carolina, with her parents Dan and Jean Dinwiddie and her 16-year-old brother Drew. After completing an art history degree at Randolph-Macon Women's College in Lynchburg, Virginia, Dail returned to South Carolina to enroll at the University of South Carolina for graduate studies. While she waited for the year to start, she spent her time taking art classes and even volunteered at the Columbia Museum of Arts. She also babysat for John Parker, the 8-year-old son of a family friend. On the 24th of September, Dail was due to pick him up from the bus stop and walk home. But that morning at 6:15 a.m., her father Dan noticed that she was not in her bedroom. On the night of September 23, 1992, Dail and her friends went to the William Bryce Stadium for a concert by the Irish rock band U2. The show ended around 11:15 p.m., and Dail and her friends then headed to Jungle Jim's, which was a nightclub in Five Points. Five Points was known as a hip dining and shopping district just east of Columbia City Center. At night, its bars became a hub of the city's nightlife scene, while also a favorite drinking destination for students at the nearby University of South Carolina. The area has now become more increasingly dangerous, but in the 1990s, Five Points was known to be a relatively safe environment. The nightclub was crowded on this particular night, and upon entry, Dail and her friends became separated from each other. Around 1 a.m., Dale's friends had left the nightclub after failing to find Dail, so they assumed she found a ride home or called her parents to pick her up as they did not live far from the club. However, Dail never left the club, nor did her parents ever pick her up. 15 minutes later, around 1:15, Dail asked the bouncer if he had seen her friends, to which he replied he did not. After another 15 minutes, Dail was seen exiting the bar and walking north on Hardin Street, wearing a forest green pullover, faded jeans, and a blue L.L. Bean jacket tied around her waist. And since then, no one has seen or heard from Dail. The following morning, Dail's father Dan woke up to let the family dog out, and upon peeking into Dail's room, he noticed she was not there, and her lights and radio were still on. When he asked the family if they've heard from Dail, they all said that they haven't. Her parents immediately knew that something sinister must have taken place. Dail's mother immediately phoned the parents of the boy that she babysat and told them about Dail's disappearance and wanted to make sure his mother would pick him up from his stop. The parents then reported Dail missing at around 8:30 a.m. that morning. This was unlike Dail to not contact the family on her whereabouts or not show up to babysit, as she was a very responsible person. She stood barely 5 feet tall and weighed about 95 pounds. She appeared vulnerable and far younger than her actual age. She also wasn't at all adventurous and hated to go to places alone. Therefore, the Columbia police treated her disappearance as a kidnapping, and the search for Dail continued. Thousands of flyers were posted everywhere with Dail's picture, and her friends were questioned, to which they responded that they thought that she left before they did. The bouncer was the last person to see her that night. The police also investigated the route she would have taken home and found nothing. Furthermore, no witnesses had came forward in any possible sightings of Dail Dinwiddie. Over the years that followed, the police looked into many different leads and suspects regarding the case. One suspect was Ronaldo Javier Rivera, who admitted to killing 4 women out in Georgia and is suspected of many more. He was from Puerto Rico but lived in Columbia and actually schooled at the University of South Carolina in 1992. He was convicted of killing a police officer in 2004 and sentenced to death and still sits in prison. However, the police could not find any evidence linking him to Dale's disappearance, so no charges were ever filed against him. In 2012, artist Debbie Goff released an age progression photo of Dale, where she would have been 43 at the time. Yet, it would still bring no leads to her case. The most recent lead took place in 2020, where there were rumors that an arrest was imminent in relation to Dale's case. An attorney was named and said to have maybe been involved in her disappearance due to a claim a woman made who said that the man had allegedly sexually assaulted her and told her that she reminded him of Dale. However, no charges were brought against him in relation to Dale's case, and as such, the case remains open and unsolved. In 2019, there was a highly publicized case that had striking similarities to the disappearance of Dail Dinwiddie. A 21-year-old woman named Samantha Josephson was reported missing from the same area Dale was last seen, right outside of Five Points in downtown Columbia. She would enter a car believing it was her Uber, but it would be 24-year-old Nathaniel Rowland's car she entered, and soon a fateful mistake. Like Dale, Samantha was a young, bright woman on a night out. She was also set to graduate that year and had plans on pursuing graduate studies, just like Dale did. But unlike Samantha's family, Dale's family have yet to find her. 29 years later, where Dale would now be 52, they still have no idea whether she's alive or what had ever happened to her. Although no death is ever a teachable moment, I would like to remind you all to stay safe and follow the proverb I personally always follow. If we go together, we leave together. Always make sure you leave with your friends, or at the least, that your friends depart safely. If you have any information on Dale, please visit the sources in the description below. Take care and thank you for watching.